Hey everyone, welcome back to the Scriptcase Macros course. Today we're looking at two different macros, SQL Injection and SQL Protect. So my name is Nate Carpenter. I'm the instructor leading this. Let's go ahead and get started and look at what these do. So SQL Injection protects a field or variable value from SQL Injection. So it basically puts quotes around it to protect it. And then SQL Protect protects a date value specifically from SQL Injection for a specific database type there. So if there's different values for different databases, it'll do that. So let's look at the first one here. So SQL Injection. So you pass through the field or the variable there, and it'll go ahead and escape it like needed. So let's go ahead and copy that, and we can take it over there. So this works for lookup or SQL select. And so yeah, here's a couple different examples here, and we can copy one of those here and take it over to the script case in just a second. This is where it's done. And then down here is the SQL Protect. So we pass in a value and then the type, which is date right now, and then the connection. It'll use the default connection if you don't inform the connection variable there. And then the only type is date, as you can see there. So here's an example of that being put into SQL select where add. So this can be used in some different situations here. I've got a blank application set up here, so we can do this. And I'm going to go ahead and do a basic query here from one of my tables here. So let's go back here to the documentation and let's go ahead and copy one of the SQL injection macro options here. So we can go ahead and copy this right here, like we said before, take that over to my Scriptcase environment here and paste it in there. So what we need here is we need a variable to pass in here. So we're going to do a regular PHP variable with a dollar sign here. So call it val here, and then we can put in a value. So this is going to be a name. The field is going to be a name from our actor table. So val equals John, and then pass in that to the SQL injection macro like so. And then this is going to be a part of an SQL select statement here. So I'm going to select all the values here from our actor table. So I'm going to go ahead and type that in from actor, and it's going to be where first underscore name is the name of that field, equals our value that we get from our SQL injection macro. So that's going to be protected. So if the user entered that, you're not going to have any SQL injection vulnerabilities there. You can go ahead and run that. We're going to use the SQLookup macro here and go ahead and put in that SQL there, and then put in the variable that we're going to save it to like so. And then we can go ahead and dump that variable to screen just to prove that it worked. And then make sure all my code is formatted correctly here. And we go ahead and run this and it should work here. So wait for it to load, and there we go. So there is our result that we got from that query. So it worked correctly, which means everything was escaped correctly as well. So that's how you use the SQL injection macro. Let's go ahead and look at our SQL protect macro now. So that one's pretty simple too. We just need to swap out this macro here to SQL Protect. And let me go over to the documentation and copy that example. So that's going to be down below, actually, going the wrong direction here on the page. There we go. So let me copy that. And let's copy that whole line. So we need the value, type, and connection. And let's go back over to Scriptcase and put that in right here. So this time we're going to do this as an input variable. This is one of the options we can do for this. So instead of using that val variable, we're going to do it as an input, and it's going to be a date. So we're going to do it on the last update field, which is a date field. So it only supports type, and it's going to be val, but we're going to put it in the square brackets, which is going to make Scriptcase ask for it when we run this. So we can delete that. And then we need to add our type and our connection. We're just going to do type. Connection is going to be left to the default. So type is date, as we would expect. And then we can go ahead and run this. And it should work like we saw before. We might not get anything for this. So it's asking for that val. So put in a date, and this date may not have any records matching our database. But as you can see, we get an empty array back like so, which means the query executed successfully. So that's how you use the SQL injection and protect macros to protect your SQL queries against different vulnerabilities.